teacher, my teacher, my old teacher. I just found out that he died. He died 11, 12, 13 years ago. And so it's all new. It's all new information. Willem Christensen. Now, Willem Christensen is a co-founder of American of two major American ballet companies, the Ballet West and the San Francisco Ballet. Now, he was my teacher for only a year straight, but my gosh, it was a close confined teaching situation with only a few girls. So it was a very great experience. I ended up dancing the Peter and the Wolf, the birdie, the little birdie, under his tutelage, up on the ladder. So up on the ladder high, and my gosh, what a fool, what a fool. The whole time frame, you know, I'm young, I think 14 years old or something. And during this time frame, he is in love with one of the girls in my classroom. And that's okay, because, well, she's beautiful, and that's the way it goes. But he was a demanding teacher, and he definitely had the favoritism for the one girl in the classroom. And she was beautiful, so I cannot blame him for this. But we had a very, very tight, very tight-knit class with only maybe four or five of us. Very small class at his academy. And so it was serious dancing. He had a cane that he used to tap on the ground, you know, so very serious dancer. What can I say? But my gosh, I thought he was still alive. He is so fresh to me that he is alive. You know what I mean? He's that kind of person that still lives. So fresh with his in vigor, his vibration for dance. His absolute life for the dance is absolutely non-stoppable, even after his death. Through me. So it's interesting. It's an interesting character, Mr. C. Now, so my big memory, like a fool, there were three girls, and we went off hiking. It was the day before our big the week before our big performance at the Capitol Theater there. And we were supposed to be dancing the Peter and the Wolf special. Big tickets and everything, and I went hiking and I twisted my ankle extremely badly, just practically broke it. But it did not matter, I continued, and I still danced. I hiked up the ladder and I hiked down that ladder, and I still danced. And I twisted my ankle on the stage. I reached for that pique arabesque and it went crunk. And I'm like, oh my gosh, and I have to still dance, because that was like one of my first steps for the piece. But yeah, it was one of those moments in life, you know, it's just you crunk your ankle on the stage and you keep dancing. And my goodness, yeah. So this is a warning to any of you young ones, do not go hiking out into the forest, in the wilds, on your the week before or a few days before any of these performances major in your life, you know, it's a stupidity. And so I ended up in an absolute ruin, you know. This ankle is weak now the rest of my life, you know, from that one moment, you know, three girls going hiking into the rain, you know, how stupid of us. But so there it is. My gosh! So Mr. C, what is the name? A respect. There's instant respect with Mr. C, with all of us. We could not help it. He's always giving us absolute directions, pure directions, pure source. You know, pure source. It's like you're dealing with the code of dance. You know, the absolute code of dance. Coming through him, he's just like had everything down into the patterns, you know, just back to a time that the other teachers, I've had so many teachers before this moment, so many other teachers, and he had never ever you know he was different. He was different from the others. The others are just, you know, going to the repertoire, the repertoire, the repertoire, the repertoire. But no, he is telling you how specifically to get through that repertoire. And it is a line. There is a line. There's a lot of lines that we have to flow through. So that's what I learned through Mr. C. And apologies for not knowing before his death. But my gosh, what a wonderful experience in my life to have known him, to actually been his student there in Utah. He's a wonderful man. Regardless his flirtations with the one girl extra, and how we all felt dissed, you know, the other girls, oh my gosh, it was me, he's not after me, he's old then too, he's extremely old, but it does not matter, he was extremely charming in his flirt, and so it was the others, we did feel like, well, she's a lucky, you know, she's a lucky one. So that's the way it goes. That's the way it goes. But yes, he did many things for us. Taught us many tricks. And I can't tell you them. I'm sorry. I don't know. You know, there's a lot of sharing out here on the internet. You know, do it this way, do it that way. But I don't want to share with the world every trick. Why would I share with the world every trick, you know? You don't deserve it. You know, I have not received for the giving of any trick. So why would I give more tricks, you know what I mean? Yeah, so anyway. So I'm very happy to talk about him, actually. I hope he didn't die terrible, but yeah, this is all part of this discussion here. I'm in this ballet embassy, like pretty much the rest of my life. You know, we're talking the danse classique, you know, for all of Europe, right here. You know, talking about that. I'll make another video specific for it. But yeah, So. He was a great man. I believe also I also danced for Harold Christensen at the San Francisco Ballet, but he was not quite the same charming. He was not the same charming as Willem. Willem was definitely the flirt, and so we learned. You know, there is a kitschness. There is a kitschness to dance. You know, there is a kitsch. There is a cutesy. There is a moment where we are. Objects. You know, we're objects. Objects. Simply an object. Yeah. So I'll put it that way. That was my secret. I'll tell. But yeah, great. Just a regular normal class he gave. Just a regular normal class with the cane pounded out on the floor. That was all. It was not anything stupendous. Not any new tricks of hey, we're going to do something spectacularly different from dance and make something new, like, you know, like Maggie Black, you know, lean away from the bar all of a sudden. We're not doing anything like this. It was just regular straightforward dancing. And a phenomenal man for that. Because I still have it in my body. I still have it to this day, you know, some of those basic ballet steps. So it's very, very intriguing. Very intriguing. How important it is to have a pure technique, rather than this whatever, you know. Yeah. All right. So yeah, thank you, Mr. C. Off into the land of the carbon. Thank you very much for your training. Appreciate it.